Last 2 years, three people have died of heroin overdoses in DeForest. Today, police stepped up efforts to prevent further tragedy. NBC 15's Barclay Pollitt takes us inside DeForest High School for more on this story.
It's near the end of the day at DeForest High School when sophomores begin to file into the auditorium. They're not there for a pep rally. Instead, they're there to learn about heroin, other drugs, and prevention.
We want our students to be safe. We want to have a healthy environment for them to learn in.
Chris Miklos, one of the school's counselors, is responsible for bringing in Detective Sergeant James Pertzborn and the DeForest Police Department to talk about a problem they say is booming.
Over the past 2 or 3 years, it's become extremely popular.
Detective Sergeant Pertzborn says many of the crimes being committed in DeForest now are either directly related to heroin or to the highly addictive drugs use.
Many of the users that I've interviewed over the past couple years have told me that they tried heroin and immediately knew they were hooked.
But the most powerful message may not have come from the police department. It probably came from Carol Beege, whose son died of a heroin overdose.
I knocked on his door and he didn't answer, and I knew that he was not going to answer. So I went in and my son was dead.
Beege's son was a graduate of DeForest High School. Her message, along with the message from the other speakers, wasn't lost on the school's current students.
I don't know how she lives her life without a kid now.
Heroin is getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and it's no longer drinking and smoking pot.
Officials say the reality is this drug isn't going away, but they hope today's assembly will help slow its deadly spread. In DeForest, Barclay Pollock, NBC 15 News.
Detective Sergeant Pertzborn says many heroin users start off with prescription meds, then move to heroin because it's cheaper and easier to get.